Hi, welcome back to Blue Tiger Academy. Today we're going to take a look at how we can implement custom metadata types in Salesforce. This section of Salesforce can help prevent you from having to hard code IDs and names into your development like flows, your Apex classes, Apex triggers, and other areas of Salesforce. So let's hop right in and check out and see how this works. So we have a very simple screen flow here that allows a sales user to request a campaign to marketing. If I open up this first screen, we can see we ask the user to enter the name, date, and description. And then we're creating the campaign record right after they enter that information. We have the name, the start date mapped, the record type ID mapped, and we can see here that we have the ID hard-coded into the flow. Whenever you're creating a new record from flow, you cannot use the record type name. You have to use the record type ID. And this is not a best practice to hard code your IDs into your flow. Let's say you were building this in a sandbox, which you should always do, and then you deploy it to production, and your record type ID didn't exist in production prior to your deployment. Your ID is now different in production, and you would have to go and manually change it in your flow and anywhere else that you have hard coded it. Custom metadata types allow you to store these IDs in one record, and then you only have to change the value in one place. So let's see how that works. I'm going to go into setup here. Go in the quick find, and we're going to type in custom meta. Click on custom metadata types. Click New Custom Metadata Type. And you will see this screen looks a lot like when you're creating a custom object in Salesforce. Go ahead and give it a label, the plural name, and click Save. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to create the custom fields that are going to hold the name and ID and object data for our custom metadata type records. The first field is going to be called record type ID. It's going to be a text field, and it will have 18 characters. Our second field is going to also be a text field, and it's going to be record type name. We're going to create a third field. This will be a text field also, and it will be called object. Now we have our three fields created. Now it's time to enter in the records for this record type setting. I'm going to open up the campaign object, and we're going to go to record types, and we'll see that we have four different record types on this object. We're going to click on the sales record type, and we can get the ID of the sales record type from the URL up here. So let's go back to our custom metadata type, and we're going to click Manage Record Type Settings. Then we'll click New. And we're going to enter a label. I like to enter the label as the name of the object dash the record type name. So in this case, it's going to be campaign-sales. And then the ID will be the ID that we copied from the URL on the sales record type. The name is going to be sales, and the object is going to be campaign. We will click Save here. So this is our first record in this custom metadata type record type setting. if you're going to reference the other record types on the campaign object in other areas of Salesforce, you can go ahead and create a record for each record type. So I can set up the one for email. I would go to record types, click email, click my ID, paste my ID into here, change the name to email, and click save. So now if I go to my record type setting and I click manage records, I can see my two records here. I'm going to create a new view because I want to be able to see all of the fields that exist on all of my records. So I'm going to drop these three custom fields over here. So there we can see our object, the ID, and the record type name. Now let's pop over to our flow and let's see how we can query this custom metadata type and then prevent us from hard coding the ID into our flow. I'm going to do a get records, and I'm going to get the record type setting. So this, the custom metadata types create an object. And our flow is not seeing it. So I'm going to hit cancel and I'm just going to hit refresh here. All right, let's try that again. We'll do a get records. Let's check and make sure that there we go. So we can see that it says record type setting MDT. That stands for metadata type. So that's what we want to choose. We will call it get record type setting. And then we want it to get the record type for sales specifically, right? So in your query, you don't want to use any of the parts of the custom metadata type record that may change. Meaning later on down the road, your business may want to change the name of the sales record type, or they may want to change the name of the email record type. So we don't want to reference either one of those in our flow. The one thing that you want to make a rule about not changing is the developer name of your custom metadata type records. So here, I should never change campaign_sales or campaign_email. So I'm going to copy that. And I'm going to say, look for the record in the record type setting, custom metadata type, where the developer name equals campaign_sales. I'll click done. And then here, I can replace my ID with the record type ID of the get. So now I am no longer storing the ID in my flow, I am querying the ID from my custom metadata type. I'll do a save as and a save. And then I will debug it here before I activate it to make sure that it's working. I'll click run here. I'll enter in some test data. And then I'll click next. And we got the success message. And here's the ID of our campaign. And let's just go check it out and make sure that it got created correctly. So I'm going to paste the ID over here. And we can see here that the record type is sales on this campaign. So it was created successfully. You've successfully prevented hard coding of IDs within your Salesforce flows. Well, that's it. That's a wrap. If you have any questions about this video, or you would like to see a tutorial on another area of Salesforce, let us know in the comments below. And as always, if you like this video, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy. Thank you. Take care. We'll see you next time. Bye.